The natural born again, you born by your mother. Your father got with your mother, and they got pregnant. And you was naturally born.
Right.
Actually, that was the birth of the human nature of you.
Right.
Your human nature was born. But there got to be a spiritual birth. Read that again. Jesus answered, "Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of what?
Water and of the Spirit.
He cannot enter into the what?
Kingdom of God."
Now come down to verse 4. Now that's the initial of getting into the church.
Right.
Come down again. 4. Come on down. 3. Jesus answered, "I say unto him, verily, verily, I say to thee, except a man is born again, he cannot see." See the word see?
Right.
Your eyes won't step foot on it. You cannot see the kingdom of God.
Amen.
Now, when you get baptized in Jesus' name, you get filled with the Holy Ghost, you're born again and they bring you into the church.
Right.
Now, when you hear, there got to be a birth of the mind.
Amen.
If there's no birth of the mind, go to 1 Peter, chapter 1. And read verse 22. Chapter 1, verse 22. First Peter, chapter 1, verse 22. All right, go there. I'm going to read it. "Seeing you have what? Crucified your souls in obeying the truth." See, you got to obey truth.
Right.
"Though through the Spirit to the unfringed love of the brethren, see that you love one another with a pure heart from verse 23, being born again." Now here's another born again. Go over there. Come on, I got time to play. Go to 1 Peter 1:22. Hey, don't play on that impurity. You gotta be quick. Now look here. Seeing you have what?
Purify your soul.
Seeing you have to do what? Purify your soul in obeying the what?
The truth.
The truth. Now notice, who see truth? Well, we're gonna come right back here. Go to St. John 17:17. "Sanctify them through what?
Thy truth.
Thy word is truth."
Amen.
Who see word?
Amen.
And I can't understand how people see it and won't do it.
Right.
I hear them say, "That was for back in that day." How you get that smart?
Right.
I'm going to tell you, how do a person get that smarter than God?
Right.
Hey, they better off say, "Well, I ain't ready yet. I'd rather hear that." Then a person say, "That was back in that day. That was for them back in that day."
Right.
Go over to see, show me where he's the same yesterday and is today. Find it. Now you gotta say to sanctify means to separate him. Now look at it. Same yesterday and today. Now I had to quit. Same yesterday and it is today. He don't change. We change, but he don't. Jesus Christ the what?
The same yesterday.
He was the same yesterday, and today, and forever.
Right.
It don't change.
Amen.
If Jesus don't change, the word don't change.
Right.
That's why you got so many religious folk coming up with newly religion.
See?
I had this brother go tell me, he's an Israelite. I said, get baptized in Jesus' name then.
Right.
He told me this morning. I'm trying to eat my breakfast. I don't care what you eat. Be an ape, all I care. I'm trying to eat breakfast. Right. Somebody say,
amen.
You know, people want to be, and they try to use fancy words.
Right.
Tell me he's speaking Hebrew. That ain't going to do us no good.
Right.
What if I got up here and spoke Chinaman? Could anybody out there understand it? So what good is going to do us?
Right.
If you ever see a real Pharisee, they'll show off, they'll pray in the airport in front of everybody.
Right.
They want to be seen.
Right.
He wasn't nothing but a Pharisee.
Right.
Tell him he speak Hebrew. Okay, what you speak?
Right, amen.
Speak all the languages you want.
Amen.
Tell him he don't believe in the New Testament. Well, God don't believe in you.
That's right.
You got to have a mother and a father in order to raise kids. That's right. So you got to have the Old Testament and the New Testament to raise a saint.
Right.
Amen. So, man. Jesus Christ the same what?
Yesterday
and today and what else?
Forever.
And you can't change forever.
Right.
Forever is what it is.
Amen.
Who is it?
Amen.
Now go back. Now watch this. Sanctify. Sanctify them through thy what?
Thy truth.
What is true?
Thy word is truth.
The word is truth. Anybody hear
me? Amen.
The word is true. Now look, as thou hast sent me into the world, even so have I also sent them into the world. And for their sake I sanctify what? That they also might be sanctified through what?
True.
Through the word. Not your opinion. Quit listening to folks. They ain't got no Bible to go with they say.
Amen.
They talk a good game. Whip.
Right.
But they ain't got no Bible to go with it.
Right.
Like I told that fellow this morning, I said, where's your Bible?
Right.
Who cares you speak Hebrew? Where is your Bible?
Right. That's it.
Who cares what your opinion is? Where is your body.
That's it.
Somebody say
amen.
Amen.
Go to St. John 7:37. Now watch this. In the last days, and we down there because the last days started on the day of Pentecost.
Right.
The great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried saying, if any man thirst, let him come unto me and what?
Drink.
Don't try to bring them with you. You save yourself. It's at him.
Yeah.
Read. He that believeth on me as the what?
Scripture.
As the scripture. Now he didn't hear himself this morning. He quoted a scripture out of the New Testament and he said he don't believe in the New Testament.
Yeah. Right.
Well, quit quoting stuff out of there.
Right.
Right.
So, baby,
right.
He that believeth on me, not on them.
Right.
On me as the what?
Scripture
has said. Out of his what?
Belly.
Out of his heart. His belly is his heart. Shall flow what?
Rivers
with an S. Rivers of what?
Living water.
Anybody see that?
Amen.
Living water. That's the Holy Ghost.
Right.
Them see them rivers? That's the Holy Ghost. Rivers are living water.
Right.
Who hear me?
Amen.
Now, go to St. John 3:4-5.
Come
on,
Jay.
Because I'm talking about the apostles' doctrine
right.
today. And look, Nicodemus said unto him, how? Who over how.
Right.
See, Jesus was simple. He wasn't like y'all trying to be so good with big words.
Right.
You know, the guy didn't even see himself how foolish he looked. Talking about Hebrew and we don't even understand what he was talking about.
Right.
How many of y'all believe in Yahweh? Raise your hand. You know why you didn't raise your hand? You didn't know what it was. Because you're English. How many of you believe in Jesus? Amen. Well, hello. We know that name.
Right.
So don't speak China to me. Speak English. I don't care what, hey, we call him Jesus.
That's right.
Well, the Hebrew word, they don't have J. Yeah, I know that. But I've been calling him Jesus, that's the English word.
Right.
I'm not Hebrew.
That's right.
I'm an English man.
Right.
Amen.
I speak English.
That's right.
Do you speak the English? We call him what?
Jesus.
Nicodemus said to him, how can a man be born when he's old? Can he enter the second time into his what?
Mother's womb.
Don't you know that to kill your mama?
Right.
And be born? Jesus answered, verily, verily, I said to thee, except a man be what? A water in the what?
Spirit.
In the spirit, he cannot enter into the what?
Kingdom of God.
Now notice that. Now, that's the initial water baptism, being born again.
Right.
But this right here got to be born. The mind.
Right.
The mind got to give birth to the word. Go to 1 Peter. Chapter 1, verse 22, 23, what did it say? Being what?
Born again.
Now here goes another being born. Now you was initially baptized, Jesus didn't feel the Holy Ghost. If you don't get education and tutoring, you won't be born again.
Right.
You can't say I baptized, Jesus didn't get filled with the Holy Ghost, and that's it.
Right.
Now you gotta be developed with the word.
Right.
Being born again, this is not a magical show. Where you, once you get baptized in Jesus' name and filled with the Holy Ghost, that's it. No! There got to be word imported into your brain to give birth to the brain.
Amen.
And that's why a doctor, who all wanna be a doctor? You just can't say that. You got to go to what? School.
Amen.
And you got to spend so much time in school. Then when you graduate, you got to go to undergraduate. Then you got to get practice. You always be practicing. Because what? The mind got to give birth to being a doctor.
Right.
So the mind got to be birthed into being a saint.
Right.
Oh, yeah. It don't come overnight. There must be a metamorphosis.
Right.
Anybody know what a metamorphosis is? From a caterpillar to the butterfly.
Right.
Notice, the caterpillar crawls around, but the butterfly flies. The nature has been changed.
Right.
From a caterpillar to a butterfly. Two natures.
Right.
Two different natures. Why? The caterpillar got to eat more when he's a caterpillar.
Mm-hmm.
Who hear me?
Yep.
That's right.
And he eat that food, he got to eat a lot in order to become a butterfly. Mm-hmm. You'd be surprised so many caterpillars and tadpoles that die because they have not ate enough to develop to become that different nature.
Right.
Go read. A tadpole, he sits up under the bottom of the water and he eats. I'm talking about he eats all day. If he don't get enough, he dies. He do not develop into a frog. He eat and then he hop out that water. He can eat on the bottom and he can come up and eat up on top and get some air. And the more he got to eat more and more in order to become a frog. Yep. If he don't get enough food, he will die. Amen. Amen. He got to eat. Go to Jeremiah 3:15. Watch this. And I will give you what?
Pastors.
According to what? Which shall what?
Feed you.
If the pastors don't feed you, you will not become a saint.
Right.
Amen.
You will die there on crack somewhere. You will die there in the streets.
Amen. Mm-hmm.
You will die there unsaved and think you're saved.
Right.
Because why? You don't have enough nourishment to become a saint. You gotta eat until that word goes down in you.
Right.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Somebody said, man. That motherfucker cuss when they get mad. They don't care. They cuss our kids. They do not care. Come on. They have not been transformed.
Right. That's it.
They still in the tadpole stage and been in church for 30 years, sitting here and eat and have not flipped over to the other side.
Right.
Who is it?
Right.
I'm asking a question. Why everybody else ain't cussing like you? You cuss like a sailor.
Right.
Jenny try to blame it on the pills you take. Look, y'all quiet. I don't care.
Right.
Hey, I preach to the mice up in there.
Yeah.
Right.
You see that pastor? His job is to feed you. Why come here? You gonna still keep on cussing?
That's it.
Hey, do something. Fight. Do something.
Amen.
I will give you pastors according to my heart. With your what? With what? And that's what develops you into a saint. Hey, if you don't reach that stage, you ain't gonna make it.
Right.
Come on. It takes prayer. It takes feeding.
Right. Yes, it does.
You gotta get that in your system so you can be transformed in your mind.
Amen.
Because he said, a man must be what? Born again. Just like that doctor gotta give birth to being a doctor. Anybody? I went to the hospital one time. And the doctor was checking me out, right? He came in. I said, he must be a nurse. He's like a little boy. And I looked at him. I said, man, how are you? I said, how long you been practicing this stuff? I was just asking him questions. Because he looked too young. He's like about 17 working on me. I said, you the doctor? I said, man, please, can you get an older gentleman here?
Right.
You practicing.
Right.
And the real doctor came in, he was seasoned, his hair was gray, and I felt confident with him. And he explained, I'm training him. I said, don't train him on me.
Right.
Amen.
Wait a minute. Because he might make a training mistake.
Right.
Wait a minute.
Amen.
And have me dead.
Right.
And so many folks dead because somebody was practicing on you.
Right.
And you women got to be careful, because they'll open you up and you'll never be the same again. I will give you what? According to what?
Mine heart.
With your what?
Feed you.
With what?
Knowledge and understanding.
If you don't get that in your system, you will not be born again.
Right.
Amen.
Y'all had these kids, you didn't have sex and here come the baby. It had to be developed. It took 9 months for you to have that baby.
Right.
And the pain that you had. Anybody?
Right.
the pain. Just like the pain of flipping over to a saint. It's the pain of letting go.
Right.
You gotta let go so you can develop.
Right.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
I had a tape of me. I think I was preaching for about 1 year. And I played it. Man, I sound like a little kid. I could tell I wasn't seasoned. Who was that?
Right.
I didn't have no experience. I said, that me? Who am
I? Amen.
Now my voice changed. It's seasoned. What happened? Problems produce this. Pressure.
Right.
Hey, if you ain't got no problems and pressure, you can't grow.
Right.
Because change don't come overnight.
Amen.
Anybody ever been in something and you just tired of it, it's time to go to the next level. You can't stay there or you'll never grow. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Hey, you cannot stay in that same place and stay in that same life. Hey, you got to grow. When I was younger, right, I stayed with my brother. He had his own little pad and everything. But I had to leave there.
Right.
Because I wasn't going to grow in and sleeping in one of his rooms.
Amen.
Who is it? So I left. He didn't want me to leave, but I left. I got me a, I thought his place was nice. And I left it because I got to go get my own.
Right.
I didn't believe in shacking up with folks.
Right.
I had to go get my own. So I went and got me a black and white TV with a single bed. And I slept in that, but that was my home.
That's it.
Then I developed from there, so I got me a little shoebox and put it on my bed and put all my money in there. Then I went and got me a two-bedroom. Then I started fixing it up a little bit at a time. Come on. I couldn't do that with him. I had to leave so I could develop.
Right.
People can hold you back. But you know what? Even though that room was raggedy, it was small, I enjoyed it. It was like being in the suburbs.
That's
to
it.
Me.
Right.
And I had time to grow. Because I wanted my own. Who understand what I'm saying?
Right.
I don't want to live off nobody off their little dream.
Right.
That's their dream. I'm going to get mine.
Right.
So when you get in church, you got to grow. You got to develop. Don't you know success is always under construction?
Right.
Who is it? You're always working on something.
Amen.
Now, a lot of times you can't see what I'm doing, but God sees it.
Amen.
Who is it? I don't even see it sometimes. But God said, just do it.
Right.
You'll see. Like my pastor told me, it took him 44 years to get here.
That's it.
And he started with 3 members and they left. Anybody?
Amen.
Look, the 3 members he started with, they left. You know what they said, Curtis? They said he was too mean, so he left. I had a lady come here. She had plenty of money. She said, I started on High Street. She said, you just getting started? I said, yes, ma'am. She came to church a couple times. She said, I'll be back when you develop. Hey, baby.
Right.
So I told the pastor, he said, God might not let her back. Because he brought her there to help with the ministry, and she didn't want to help. That's what they was. She didn't want to spend no money.
Right.
I bet she broke now. Whoever.
Right.
God sent her there to help me. But she didn't want to share with God. What'd they say? Man, you don't share them with God. God had everything. He will bless you with abundance of things. Hey, being blessed ain't what you have. We think being blessed is material things. Cars and houses. That ain't blessed.
Right.
Because why? The dope man got that.
Amen.
Wilson back there, he got plenty of money. All the money his wife doesn't get. But look, I will give you pattern according to my what? We shall feed you in what?
Knowledge and understanding.
Knowledge and what? Understanding. You gotta be fed like that taco. So you become a frog.
Right.
Anybody?
Man.
Yeah, we do it. Man, fool, these folk make you cuss. No, that's cussing that's in you.
Right.
Can't nobody make you do nothing. Pressure produce what's down in you.
Right.
If you want to know who you are, put the pressure on you. And everything that's in you coming up.
Yeah.
If you're a cusser, when pressure comes, you can be cussing like a sailor.
Mm-hmm.
Without you even knowing about it.
Yeah.
And you both had the Holy Ghost, and the Holy Ghost don't tell you, you know you're supposed to be doing that.
Right.
I know the Holy Ghost. Hey, when I do wrong, I know the Holy Ghost talk to me. I know right from wrong. I ain't stupid. Can I tell you something? I knew right from wrong before I came into church. You did too. If it wasn't wrong, why we ducking?
Right.
Now, who's he there?
Amen.
Go to 2 John 3 and 7. You see that? Marvel not. See that marvel? Jesus has seen the shock in their face. That's why he said marvel not. He was so surprised. When Jesus said it, they were shocked. And you ever seen somebody that was shocked?
Right.
Marvel not that I say to thee, you must what?
Be born again.
You must be born again. Who's he there?
Right.
Oh, take it back. He talking about baptism in Jesus' name. If it, no, I ain't. I'm talking about this word that they got to give birth to the brain.
Yeah.
If you're not born again, you ain't going to make it. And that means the word. Who's he there? My or not that I say to thee, ye must. Who's he the word must?
Amen.
You must drink water to live.
Right.
You must eat food to live. And you must be born again to go to heaven.
Amen.
It ain't a choice. It ain't our choice. Jesus said it.
Right.
He
right.
said you must.
Must.
It's kind of hard here today.
Right.
You must be born again.
Yes, Lord.
Must. Hey, don't be shocked.
Right.
Who hears?
Amen.
Now look at this. You must. The wind blows where it was. And thou hears the what?
Sound.
See that sound? The sound of the voice. Who hears?
Amen.
It's the voice of the wind.
Right.
Read. The wind blow away, listen, thou hearest the sound thereof, but cannot tell whence it cometh or whether it was. So is everyone that is born of the what?
Spirit.
I've seen this guy. He said he had been filled with the Holy Ghost and he was saved. I said, can you repeat it? He said, yeah. I said, you don't have it.
That's it.
Because if you can repeat it, that ain't of God.
Mm-hmm.
Only God can speak this.
Right.
Read. Read again. The wind blowing where it listen, thou hearest the sound there, but cannot tell. You don't know where it's coming from.
Right.
If you don't know where it's coming from, you sure don't understand it.
Nope. No, you don't.
Or where to go. If you don't know where it went, so is everyone that is born of the what?
Spirit.
When God fills you with his spirit, you don't know where it came from and you don't know where it went. So if you don't know where it came, you can't repeat it.
Right.
If you don't know where it went, you can't repeat it.
Right.
Go to, let me show it to you. Let me show it. Go to Acts 2 and 4. Hey, you got to be baptized in Jesus and you got to be filled with the Holy Ghost. And you got to deal with the Holy Ghost. Folk got to get the Holy Ghost. Don't come here telling me you need to get baptized only. No, you got to have the Spirit.
Amen.
Look, they were all filled with the what?
Holy Ghost.
And began to speak with what?
Holy tongues.
That elder. Read.
The Spirit gave the utterance.
And the Spirit gave the utterance. So you can't do it. God did it.
Right.
Go, now we're going to come right back here. Go to St. John 4 and 24. Now watch this. God is a what?
Spirit.
Who gave utterance?
God.
Why? God is a what?
Spirit.
God is a what?
Spirit.
He's a spirit. God is a what?
Spirit.
And the Greek is that God is spirit. Who see that?
Right.
God is spirit.
Amen.
In other words, God is not a man.
No, he's not.
He's not flesh and bones. He's a spirit.
Right.
He is.
And they call it the invisible God.
Uh-huh.
Now go back over there. Who see God as spirit? They were all filled with what?
The Holy Ghost.
Now notice. They were all filled with tongues.
The Holy Ghost.
No, they was all filled with the Spirit first. And then began to speak with what?
Other tongues.
Other tongues. So when God filled them, see that water? Just imagine that, the Holy Ghost. It was filled with water first. Then when it got filled with water, it overflowed.
Right. Uh-huh.
So when it overflowed, you heard it.
Right.
Stop.
But this is the substance right here. The water. The Holy Ghost is the substance. And when you heard it, that's when you know that this was in you.
Right.
Anybody?
Amen.
You didn't hear it until it hit the top and flowed over.
Right.
So you didn't hear the Spirit until he filled you up and it flowed over.
Right.
They were all filled with what?
With
it didn't say they was all filled with tongues.
Amen.
They were filled with the Holy Ghost first. Then they began to speak with other tongues. Then God used them, their tongues. You see that? He used their tongue, but it was other tongues.
Right.
It wasn't there. As the what?
Spirit.
Who see the Spirit?
Amen.
So who gave the utterance?
God.
So who know how God sound? God is in what?
Spirit.
Who gave the utterance? God did. As the Spirit gave them what?
Utterance.
So they were filled with the power first. Then they heard it.
Yeah.
Anybody?
Amen.
They heard it. Go to 2 Corinthians 12:12. 12 and 18. Now watch this. 1 Corinthians 12:18. Go to 1 Corinthians 12:18. Watch this. Now look here. But now, have God set who? Every one of them where? How did he put them there? How did God set the members in the body? Read 12 and 12. For if the body is what?
One.
And have what? And all the members of that one body, being many, are one body, so also is what?
Right.
Now read verse 13. I'm going to tell you how God set the members in there. For by what?
One spirit.
How many spirits?
One.
Are we all baptized where?
Into one body.
Whether we Jews or Gentiles, whether we be bond or free, have been all made to drink into what?
One spirit.
Who see that? Jew and Gentile.
Right.
That's what I got over here, Israelite. According to this, we all going in there, Jack. And we get baptized in Jesus' name and get filled with the Holy Ghost.
Right.
Who is it?
Man.
Hey, yeah, then God chose people, But God, Jesus knocked down the wall when he got on the cross and broke that wall down so everybody could come over.
Amen.
Selfish. Ain't no more pride. Tell me, I'm an Israelite. That don't make you nobody.
Right.
And I want all of us going to hell with you. Ain't no more pride.
Right.
The Bible said God so loved the world. That's everybody. He gave everybody the opportunity. There's only two kind of people in the world. Jew and Gentile.
Right.
For by one spirit are we all baptized into what? Whether it be Jew or what?
Gentile.
Don't make a difference who you are. Look. Anybody that's not a Jew is a Gentile.
Right.
Who is it? Whether we born or free, has been all. Who's in the word all?
Right.
Anybody know what all mean? Lottie, Dottie, and everybody. All made to drink into what?
One
spirit. Everybody got to have the Holy Ghost. Everybody got to be filled with one spirit. I don't care if you don't have it. According to God, you got to be filled with it if you're going to come in this church.
Man.
Look, for the body is not what? Who's he one? But what?
Many.
Who's he many? And when you see many, you don't even know the numbers.
Right.
Who's he that? Read Revelation 18. But now, not tomorrow, right now.
Right.
But now, has God sent who?
Remember.
Why did God send him in there? Because God is the one that filled him with the Spirit.
Amen.
By one Spirit.